Hi guys, it's Natalie Elphinstone here, and today I have got my daughter Mariah, who's probably going to be helping me out because she can't help herself. And today I'm going to be talking about what I call backwards Bible journaling, or putting the journaling back into Bible journaling. Quite often my approach to Bible journaling is to be reading the word and having a verse or a phrase or whatever jump out and speak to me, and then taking that as my basis for how I'm going to do my illustrations. And then after I do my illustrations and my pretty things, then I think about whether or not I've got any space left over to actually be writing my thoughts or my journaling out my response to that. Whereas today I'm taking a bit of a different approach. I'm actually going to be journaling out the notes that I took during a sermon. And so what I've got first of all is my notes, and that's where I'm going to start. Now, I'm working in Ecclesiastes, and the verse that, although it wasn't the verse that was preached on, the verse that came to mind in response to the sermon, because the sermon was talking about being at peace with the season that God has got you in, that talks to me, or what I thought of was, you know, the classic verses in Ecclesiastes 3 where it talks about there is a time and a season for everything under heaven. Now, this is Ecclesiastes 3 here, and so you can see that, in fact, this column is already illustrated. In fact, this was illustrated by Mariah on the 26th of March 2015, so almost this time last year. And so obviously I can't do any journaling on that side, so I'm going to do my journaling on this side today. And you can see I've stuck a couple of random letters here, and you might be wondering what the heck I'm doing there. What I'm doing there at the moment is just trying to work out my spacing, because I will have a title at the top, and of course, so I need to leave a bit of a space for the title. And then, as I said, my primary thing that I want to do here is to write out my journaling and get my thoughts down. So now that I know it's going to take up approximately this much space for my title, and I'm going to add that in later, but just bear with me as I go through this process, I'm actually going to go ahead and write out my journaling now. So I'm going to pop this in fast forward so that you don't have to sit through me tediously writing all of this out. All right, so now that I've written all of that out, I am actually going to remove the spacing, I think. Like usual, there's plans in my head, and then there's what's going to happen when I actually hit record on the video. And this is how I actually go ahead with my Bible journaling anyway. So I've got my journaling. This is going to be my space for my title. I've got some room at the bottom, so now I know that I have got some space for doing some decoration. And today, I think I'm going to be just drawing or doodling in, you know, one of my favorite topics at the moment, and that's a bit of a green plant, a bit of a fern, some rainforest type. Yeah, cactuses is another cacti. Leaf. Is another thing that I've been doing.
Leaf.
But anyway, this is just going to be
looks like
a bit of a leaf. And maybe another one here. I'm just doing these in grey lead at the moment. Do I like it? Doesn't really matter. I'm just going to go with it anyway. And I am going to next paint it in before I go any further. So I've just got some watercolours and my water pen. I've got my Bible journaling mat underneath to help protect.
Can I colour it in?
You want to colour it in?
Yeah. Yep.
Well, I'm just going in these lines here. Do you want to do that? Yeah. Mariah wants to have a go. Yeah, get a bit more colour.
Can I help you do this?
Sorry. You've painted before.
I've painted a ginormous leaf.
That's true, you did paint that ginormous leaf. All right, well, while Mariah paints, we might fast forward this part as well. So she's painted that in lovely, and the reason I took my title off, see, what I think I want to do now is put some colour in the background. Now, there are two ways to do this. You can, of course, either, you know, grab your paintbrush and paint in the background, and if you wanted to be pedantic, you can go around all of those leaves and come in here and down there, and that would be one way of doing it. Another way that I've been sort of loving getting creative recently is to use some masking fluid. So I'm not sure if you've ever tried using this. It's taken me a little bit of time to, I guess, no, you need to stop painting now so I can pop this on. You missed a leaf.
Yes.
It's taken me a little experimenting to get the technique sort of down with this. But in a minute. The way this works, so this is kind of like a latex thing, and you paint it over the top of where you don't want your colour to go.
Okay, I can do that.
I think I'll probably just do this one, okay?
Can I do the little leaf?
Okay.
Little leaf, little leaf. That's probably why it's called little leaf.
We'll fast forward again, hey? And in fact, we now need to wait for that to dry before we can do anything else. And then once it is dry, all I'm going to do is take some more watercolours and just paint over this whole thing. And you'll see how that's going to work later on. But I might just skip that part altogether. Otherwise, this video might go forever, I'm afraid. Okay, so with the masking fluid over the top of my drawing, what I've been able to do is very quickly just put a wash of colour all over this without needing to worry about trying to get into all the little gaps, because I know that the colour will just go wherever the masking fluid isn't. And that way, I literally just grabbed my brush and did this, and you can see, like, I've not done this very neatly. I've just splashed some colour on, and not even over the whole page. Just here, because that's about all where I wanted it to go. Thanks, Mariah. Now, this is dry. You do want it to be really, really dry, and I haven't, it's not 100% dry. As you can see, it's still kind of a bit wet here, so I'm going to be really cautious, but the best thing to do would be to leave it to be completely dry, but I'm a little bit impatient. And then what you want to do is to rub the masking fluid off. So you can either just do it with your finger.
Or just pull it off.
Or pull it off. Or you can just get an eraser, a rubber, and start gently rubbing it off that way. No, please don't. It's too fragile. It would really be better if I left this to dry all the way. So what I'm going to do is to do that, and then I'm going to rub it off like this, and then I'll come back and show you how the rest of my page is going to come together. So here's what I've done while I turned it off, and sorry, it's now getting a bit late in the day and starting to get the shadows. I apologize. So I rubbed off all of the masking fluid, and because I was impatient and didn't wait for it to dry properly, it has taken off some of the colour of the paint underneath. But I'm okay with that. Like, let me zoom in and show you. Oh, no, I can't zoom in. Let me lift it up then. See if it will focus. So that's what it looks like, and I'm okay with that sort of mottled look of it. And I've added in my title, which I just did with a combination of some Bella Boulevard tiny text stickers and the Illustrated Faith Genesis collection stickers as well. And then I'm just sort of finishing off. So what I am going to add is the date, And actually before, I'm going to pop in this little sticker that says Sermon By. This is another one of the Illustrated Faith stickers. Stick that in there.
That looks pretty.
You like it there? Maybe I just need to lift it up a little bit so I can actually write who it's by underneath.
Who's it by?
This was Sermon by Luke in our church. And the date, perhaps instead of the date of when I'm doing it today, it's going to be the date that he did the sermon, which was actually the 17th of January. So I'm going to stamp that in down the bottom. And then I feel like there's still a gap up here that I, you know, if I had planned it out better, I would add in another of these ferns and, you know, in the same technique with sort of this white masked off area like I've done with these. But given that I didn't plan that in advance, I'm going to be unable to get this sort of white background. But you know what? I think I'm going to pop one in there anyway, just, you know, to finish off this sort of triad of leaves.
Very pretty.
So it won't look quite the same. Oh yeah, so obviously I outlined the leaves on that other one with my Illustrated Faith pen, which I use for all of these sorts of things, mainly because it's like it writes really well and it's got the ability to be waterproof, so I use that a lot. I really need to be more patient, don't I? I'm smudging it now because, again, I didn't wait for it to dry.
Smudge.
So let's get that paint and add some more colour in here.
Again.
No, I'll do it this time.
Oh, last time I was very.
You were very, very good.
Quick, that's what I'm
saying. Yeah, quick is also good, hey?
Yeah, that.
You could have done that. Mm-hmm. And I think that's probably going to be it. If I add any extra little bits, it's just going to be little details here and there. But I'll obviously show you the finished project. Thanks very much for joining with me today, and hopefully you've got something out of the idea of being able to do your journaling first or allowing enough space in your Bible journaling for your journaling. Mariah says goodbye as well.
Goodbye.
See you later.